I have ordered a new contact board for my golf cart. It's an Easy Go Year Unknown, but this looked like the same board that's in my golf cart now. So, plan is to change it. Don't know what I'm doing, might as well film it along the way. Batteries are starting to show their age, but that's not a big deal. I'm gonna disconnect this one, pull it out, slide this one back so that I can have a little easier access. Now, once this is apart, you'll quickly see, I think, why I have to do this. When I first got this thing, I was like, well, contact's not the greatest down there, but it'll be fine for now. Well, for now, it's come and gone. So, time to take it apart. Now the problem with this is this massive nut. It looks like if I loosen it, I should be able to slide the entire board up. We have the gas pedal connector here. It's got a little spring clip union joint on it. So I should be able to just pry that off, depending on what condition it turns out to be in. I mean, rust is a thing after all. I got to disconnect the solenoid. I'm hoping I can take the whole thing out together and then reinstall everything. Kind of in my hand, if you will. All right, I got a huge wrench here. I'm going to see if I can't pop the gas pedal off with it in place. Now let's loosen the nut first. Monstrous nut. The base here is coming right off. That's good news. Board is pretty loose now. Speed collar is loose again. And the ball is almost out of a socket. It is now. My whole assembly slides up just as I was hoping. Looks like I get a 9/16 on my solenoid there, or half, whatever size that is. And take it from there. So we have our speeds here. 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't really need to label these. I mean, they are already anyway. But basically, you got four contacts across there. So first, second, third, fourth. First, second, third, fourth. Pretty straightforward on that one. Should have disconnected the small wire on the solenoid first. But here we are. So, get those off. Speed. Connectors, I mean. Need to reuse these, so I don't lose them all. It's under the cart, that's fine. So, I'm just gonna disconnect that. I believe it's a 3/8. I know the black background isn't the ideal place to be doing this, but that's what I got. So here we have our wiper board kind of assembly, let's call it, with the gas pedal there. So it's just a simple matter, really, of taking it all apart and putting it on the new stuff. I like impact wrenches. Makes life quite easy. Looks like a nylon lock nut. The nylon doesn't do its job anymore, so you really should consider changing that. The ball is facing downward, just so I remember later. Washers. I'm gonna get that one off now. Yeah, I might have a socket that'll fit it, but I'll use a wrench for now. Alright, let me go find a big socket. So it's 1 1/8 inches. Let's be honest, I don't have 1 1/8 inches deep socket. It's a huge socket. Sometimes I amaze myself. Turns out I do have a deep socket, 1 1/8. Who knew? A little bit of looking sure pays off sometimes. And it's just spinning. Alright, so we can slide off our centerpiece here. Then I gotta find some way to hold that back piece. Well, I kind of try to get this off. That's gonna be fun. I'll go ahead and pull the solenoid off now. Might as well. If I were some type of golf cart repairman, and I had one of these jobs come through, they would buy a new one of these. I wouldn't do this. I heated it up with a torch, so now the thing is glowing red hot. That nut's coming off, so. That's all that matters. Alright, that wasn't that bad. Maybe I wouldn't make them pay. But either way, highly specialized nut. You really don't want to screw that up. Now, what is over here still smoking? Eh, whatever. Okay, so now we just reassemble, so it's a pretty easy job. I'm going to go clean this up on the wire wheel, and yeah. So now it's a part, you can see the old board. The black is from my torch, so ignore that. But the contacts, well, it's hard to tell, but they're screwed up. There you go. See the first slow speed? See how it's indented inwards? Yeah, that's a problem. So what would happen was it would just get stuck right there. And the entire board is melted itself in. So we had something happened to this thing where that got really hot and melted itself inward. And it's just been a problem ever since. I took it out previously and I filed the spacing between here down because they used to just touch. So we turned the golf cart on and start arcing. So I kind of fixed that the best I could. Got a few, well, almost a year out of it. But the time has come for it to go because it does not work anymore. I mean, it does, you know, in that speed and that speed only. Can't shut it off, but yeah, well. Okay, nice and clean. Now we just put it all back together. Should be easy enough. I'm going to clean out the inside of this best I can. Just to give the golf cart gas pedal, electric pedal, I guess, actually. I don't know, just see if this will help it operate a little smoother. Probably an unneeded step, but Probably won't hurt anything. That's ever coming loose. Okay, now we had that little stopper piece. This thing. Yeah, I'll clean that up too. So now we have the actual, I guess wiper contact you'd call it. Time to swap that out. Now this thing was worn when I got this golf cart. And you'll quickly see what I mean. I mean, that thing is just destroyed. Probably, honestly, probably mill it down and get some more life out of it, but not doing any of that. Yep, that's pretty screwed up. Let's see the difference with the new one. Yeah, it's, a little worn, not bad. So this rides inside of this bolt, so I'm gonna go clean this up. Now I can guarantee you that dirt, dust, and sand is gonna find its way onto this pedal. I thought about greasing this when I put it in there, but like I said, dirt, dust, and sand plus grease isn't the best ideas. So I don't think I'm gonna do it. I think I'm just gonna leave it all natural and hope it rotates okay. Anyway, so that just pushes back in. Kind of a little stiff. Okay, let's reinstall some things. Tightened it down, and that thing operates quite nicely. Solenoid back on. Okay, I'm gonna slide my board assembly back down into that hole. Taking the two washers apart and right there. Beautiful. So this goes to the top. Get that out of the way. Go first. Second. And fourth. So I'll get the nuts, get those all tightened down. So far it's going quite smoothly. Gas pedal clipped right back on. And a little ball attachment thing. It's a matter of tightening down this huge nut. Now, if everything's back together, right, should be able to turn it on. I put it in gear. Let's go with reverse. My solenoid should click. It does. Now forward. And the golf cart doesn't lunge in a direction, so I think we're good. And you can really see how beat up this board is. See what I mean? It's all melted inward. Just destroyed. Let's hope it doesn't happen again. All right, moment of truth. Let's see how this goes. Oh, that's smooth. Oh, that's nice. Look at it stop. It's not lunging forward or nothing. Oh, that's beautiful. Well worth it.
So what am I doing? Just drive it?
Yeah. What the heck? What is he doing?
Really good.
A little better now?
A little.